Hi dear friends, welcome back to Curious Vet. I am Dr. Mohsina. Today I will start an important playlist regarding the lameness in equine. So this is the first video in that playlist. It is about tendinitis or bowed tendon in horses. So before going to tendinitis, please look at the anatomy of equine hoof. This is a transverse view. You can see the different bones and different parts of equine hoof here. Please pause the video and look into the details. This is a more detailed view of the basic hoof anatomy. You can see the different flexor tendons here, superficial flexor tendon and deep digital flexor tendon and extensor tendons on the ventral and dorsal aspects respectively, and different bones. This is another view from below. You can see different parts of equine hoof with a heel, quarter and toe, and the frog, apex of frog, body of sole, etc. Please pause the video and look into the details. Bite line is very clear in this picture. Cleft of frog, sole, heel, hoof wall. Everything is very clear here. So now we will see tendinitis or bowed tendon. It is the inflammation of a tendon. It can be acute or chronic with varying degrees of tendon fibril disruption. And tendinitis is most common in horses used at fast work, particularly race horses. The problem is seen more commonly in digital flexor tendons and most common in forelimb than in hind limb. These pictures show horses with bowed tendon. The arrow represents the site of lesion. You can see the deformity very clearly. There is swelling of the tendon, that is the ventral aspect of the limb. In race horses, the superficial digital flexor is involved most frequently. The primary lesion is a central rupture of tendon fibers with associated hemorrhage and edema. So these are the three types of bowed tendon: high bowed tendon, middle bowed tendon and low bowed tendon, based on the location of the lesion. You can see the site of tendon injury in the picture on the right side. Coming to the etiology, tendinitis usually appears after fast exercise and is associated with overextension and poor conditioning, fatigue, poor racetrack conditions and persistent training when inflammatory problems in the tendon already exist. Improper shoeing may also predispose to tendinitis, and poor conformation and poor training also have been implicated. Coming to the clinical findings and diagnosis, there are two stages. During the acute stage, the horse is severely lame and the involved structures are hot, painful and swollen. In chronic cases, there is fibrosis with thickening and adhesions in the peritendinous area. The horse with chronic tendinitis may go sound while walking or trotting, but lameness may recur under hard work. Ultrasonography is the main diagnostic method, which delineates the cross-sectional and longitudinal extent of the tendon. Here you can see the cross-sectional and longitudinal views. This is another cross-sectional view. Here you can see the different tendons, that is superficial digital flexor, deep digital flexor, check ligament and suspensory ligament. In this picture you can see a normal superficial digital flexor tendon on the right side and enlarged, that is a bowed tendon on the right side, enlarged superficial digital flexor tendon. This is a cross-sectional view. Coming to the treatment, tendinitis is best treated in the early acute stage. The horse should be stall rested and the swelling and inflammation treated aggressively with cold packs and systemic anti-inflammatory agents. Some degree of support and immobilization should be used depending on the amount of damage to the tendon. This picture shows how to bandage a bowed tendon. intratendinous corticosteroid injections are contraindicated when a distinct hypoechoic or anechoic core lesion is present on ultrasound examination. Tendon splitting has been recommended and the rationale is to decrease intratendinous pressure due to serum or hemorrhage. Cases also have been treated with shockwave therapy and intralesional injection of fat-derived stromal cells or cultured bone marrow-derived mesenchymal cells or platelet-rich plasma products. The level of evidence of these modalities are variable. Here you can see the picture of a shockwave therapy and intralesional injection. The host should be rehabilitated using a regimen of increasing exercise. Superior check ligament desmotomy has been used as an adjunctive treatment to minimize recurrence of the problem before the host is returned to training. Other treatments for chronic tendinitis have included superficial point firing, it is of questionable benefit, and percutaneous tendon splitting. Annular ligament desmotomy is also used when tendinitis occurs within the confines of the digital tendon sheath. The prognosis for a flat racing thoroughbred racehorse to return to racing after a bout tendon is guarded regardless of treatment. However, increasing success is seen with eventers, show jumpers and show hunters and dressage horses respectively. So that's all about bout tendon or tendinitis in equine. This is a very important topic. I have gone through only the important aspects like the etiology, diagnosis, clinical findings and treatment. So please go through all the different aspects and basically the hoof anatomy, and we will soon continue with this playlist with another important topic. So if the video is informative, please like it and comment your suggestions. Share the video with your friends. If you are new to this channel and not subscribed yet, please subscribe and click the notification bell. Thank you. See you soon with another video.